Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seat, ready and excited to analyze a video taken on the moon.
Cool. Which moon? Our moon?
Yeah, our moon.
Yep. In order to show that the acceleration due to gravity is independent of mass, in 1971, NASA filmed astronaut David Scott holding a feather and a hammer at the same height and dropping them at the same time. Let's enjoy the video.
Oh, wow, watch this. Joe, you have a good picture there. I've got the...
Beautiful picture, Dave.
Well, in my left hand, I have a feather. In my right hand, a hammer. And I guess one of the reasons we got here today was because of a gentleman named Galileo a long time ago who made a rather significant discovery about falling objects in gravity fields. And we thought that where would be a better place to confirm his findings than on the moon. And so we thought we'd try it here for you. The feather happens to be appropriately a falcon feather for our falcon. And I'll drop the two of them here, and hopefully they'll hit the ground at the same time. How about that?
How about that?
Proves that Mr. Galileo was correct in his findings.
So now what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at the video and figure out variables that we know and see what we can calculate from there. So Bobby, taking a look at the video, which I have now looped to just show the dropping of the objects, tell me a variable that we know. It looks like... Is their initial velocity zero? Yes, the initial velocity in the y direction is equal to zero because he drops the hammer and the feather. Bo, what else?
We know from the last lecture that the acceleration due to gravity on the moon is about 1/6 of what it is here on Earth, right?
Correct. However, more specifically, it's the acceleration due to gravity on the moon that is 1.62 meters per second squared. And therefore, the acceleration in the y direction, which is equal to negative little g, is equal to negative 1.62 meters per second squared. Billy, what else do you see?
Isn't the frame rate of standard definition video 29.97 frames per second? So can't we just figure out the number of frames to determine how long it fell for?
Absolutely right. Very nice, Billy. The National Television System Committee, or NTSC, standardized the color television broadcast signal in the United States in the 1950s to have a frame rate of 29.97 frames per second. And this is clearly after the 1950s and is before high-definition video. I was even born in 1971. So let's go through and count the frames.
Well, in my left hand, I have a feather. In my right hand, a hammer. And I guess one of the reasons we got here today was because of a gentleman named Galileo a long time ago who made a rather significant discovery.
Superb.
So there you go, 36 frames. We need to convert the change in time from frames into seconds. Billy pointed out that there are 29.97 frames per second in this video. Therefore, we're going to multiply our change in time by the reciprocal of the frame rate. And what do we get for our change in time? It's 1.201201 seconds. And given that information, we can figure out the initial height above the ground from which Mr. Scott dropped the hammer and feather. Bo, how can we figure out the height initial?
Well, the acceleration is constant, so we can use our uniformly accelerated motion equations. We just need to pick the right one. Let's use the displacement equals the velocity initial times the change in time plus 1/2 times the acceleration times the change in time squared. We have all the numbers, and the initial velocity is zero, and anything times zero is just zero. So the displacement equals 1/2 times negative 1.62 times 1.201201 squared, which gives us negative 1.16874, and using two sig figs, because our frame rate only had two sig figs, that rounds to negative 1.2 meters.
Very nice, Bo. One thing to notice that I did is I added y's to make sure that we identify that this is all in the y direction. For those of you who are still using English units, because there are 3.281 feet per meter, we could do this. Whew.
Which means that Mr. Scott dropped the hammer and the feather from an initial height above the ground of approximately 1.2 meters or 3.8 feet, which is approximately this high, which looks pretty close to me. Yes, Bobby, you have a question?
Mr. P, where did the negative go?
Oh, right. Okay, so the delta y, or the displacement, has both magnitude and direction. And because the hammer and feather were going down, this means that the displacements were negative. However, I asked for the height initial above the ground, which is a positive number. Any other questions?
No. Cool video.
In that case, realize that we just took a video that was filmed in 1971 on the moon, which has almost no atmosphere, and therefore the hammer and the feather were truly in free fall. We counted the frames to figure out how long they were in free fall and used a UAM equation to figure out the height initial for the hammer and feather above the ground. I think that's pretty cool. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.